Blessed is the kingdom of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, who now and forever, and unto the ages of ages. In peace let us pray to the Lord.
Lord have mercy.
For the peace from above and the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord have mercy.
For the peace in the whole world, for the stability of the holy churches of God, and for the unity of them all, let us pray to the Lord. House and for those who enter it with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Archbishop and Father, Silas, the honorable presbyters, the deacons in the service of Christ, all the clergy and the laity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our country, the president, and all those in public service, and for the armed forces everywhere, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this parish, the city, for every city and country, faithful live, and let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For favorable weather and abundance of the fruits of the earth and peaceful seasons, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by land, sea, and air, for the sick and suffering, captives, and for their safety and salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and distress, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy, bond us, and protect us, God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Remembering our most holy, your blessed and glorious day, for the Lord's every merit, all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life unto Christ our God. For to you belong all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, look down forever to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Ex pedios gen et os fodra, et bis megalosinis a tu. Glorious things were said concerning you, O city of God.
By the prayers of the Theotokos, Savior,
save us. Theos antis vades in aftis, inos que te otan antilambaniter aftis. In the city of the Lord of hosts, in the city of our God.
By the prayers of the Theotokos, Savior,
save us. Lux apatrike, o keio neva, dikei, kiai, keis, seonas, neon, non ami.
Despresides, Theotokos, sotet, sotimos.
Et quiet, gen, in incidere, come. Panagias atrandi per voi mensen, dos, tres, 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 tres Holy our God, and to you be ascribed glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
All these things we cannot speak in detail. These preparations having thus been made, priests go continually into the outer tent, performing their ritual duties, but into the second only, the high priest goes, and he but once a year, and not without taking blood, which he offers for himself and for the heirs of the people.
Peace be to you.
And to your spirit. Alleluia. 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 Hear, O darkness, and see and incline your ear to the rich among the people. Will entreat your favor.
Why Moses? He had a son. You know, could he he found somebody better? Why couldn't he have picked Pharaoh and changed his heart instead of hardening it? You know, why this? Why that? Why Adam and Eve when they would have fallen? You know, and there's so many questions that people have when they open the scripture and read it. And the question, why? But when we read, especially today's epistle, and, you know, the Gospels that we read for the Orthodox and the Divine Liturgy today are kind of preordained. We always hear the same ones, for the most part, on the feast days of the Virgin Mary, with very few exceptions. It's to remind us how obedient she was. You know, to remind us of her virtue of obedience and, you know, doing the will of God in her life. And so when we ask these questions, why, I actually find the answers in that gospel, but it's described in a different way in the epistle. Not better, not worse, just different. It's another thing that we haven't maybe thought of. Because, again, it's one of these things where we hear that our brothers and sisters in Christ talking about the Virgin Mary and say, well, anyone could have done that. Really. You know, because when we hear the epistle today, we hear about the order of the temple of God. Who can go where? Where is this place? Why is that place there? Who is going here? Why is this laid there? How is this ordained? Why is it ordained this way? Why is it placed like that? And there's this order. And the same thing happens when we enter an Orthodox church, or even a Catholic church for that matter, but especially within the Orthodox church, there is a point at which certain things take place, and they're done in a certain way. I do not open the Agnus Dei, you know, until the certain prayers are read. I don't place the gospel on the altar in a certain way until certain things are done. And it's the same way. I don't wave the iota over the gifts until the creed. Things that are done in a particular order at a particular time because of the order by which we receive them. And keeping that order reminds us that the entire heavens are not some haphazard way of praising God. It's a very ordered way of praising God. A way that leads us from glory to glory. If we do it on our own, you know, we run the risk of not, you know, following in line with the great glory that is the joy of the Lord. And so we read this epistle and realize there is a complete order, perfect order by which things should be done. And it really falls under the grace of the Lord. But we follow this order because we find freedom within it. So, in this great understanding of order, this great understanding of you know, what heaven will be like, because that's what church is, that's what our lives are, it's really heaven practice. This is what we are, we're getting used to it. We're assimilating ourselves to the glory of God within heaven. As we're doing that and we recognize that order, then we hear about, you know, we hear about angels flying before God. We hear about people offering sacrifice, incense lit, hymns that are chanted. And then all of a sudden we hear about Jesus. Well, he doesn't remind us of anything that is within the heavens because they don't have bodies up there. Not the way we know. Not the way we understand. And how did this Jesus come to be? Well, did he poof just appear on this earth? Did God create him out of dust the way he created us? No. He allowed for the order that he created and the free will that he gave us, he allowed for it to be satisfied. He allowed for all of these things. And granted, he would interfere or intervene for us in certain circumstances, not for any other reason, not to override our free will, but rather to guide us, to keep giving us signposts. Hey, this is where I'm going. This is what's going to happen. Because he knew that he was going to be a man on this earth. Even from when Adam and Eve fell. He could see the beginning of time. He could see the end of time. He knew he was going to be man on this earth. He knew that would be the perfection. He knew that's how we would have to listen. And believe me, he tried prior. You know, he tried sending the tablets of the law. It didn't work. He tried sending the patriarchs. It didn't work. In a little way it did. But it didn't work in the way of redemption of mankind. There were only a few righteous. There were only a few that could really access him in that way. The rest were lost. And so he knew he would have to come as a man so that we could hear him and understand him. This is the woman he chose. You know, and I use this analogy a lot just because it's the one that speaks to me the most. If it doesn't, forgive me. But it's not the way our brothers and sisters speak of it. The way some of our brothers and sisters speak of this woman, it's like he was spinning the globe like Commander McBragg from Rocky and Bullwinkle, and he just said, "Bam, I'll pick her." No, that's not it. How could we possibly believe that when we know how ordered the rest of his entire universe is? Read Psalm 104, the best verse Psalm. Everything has an order. You stretched out the heavens like it was a curtain. Lord, you are very great. You are indeed magnified. The ministers, the angels minister you. They're a flame of fire. The young lions roar for their prey. The valleys go up, the mountains go up, the valleys sink down to the place you have appointed for them. Everything has its place. Everything has its order. Even the Leviathan that speaks about, this great sea beast that's in the water. All of these things look to you, God, to give them their food in due season. When you give to them, they gather up, and you open your hand, they're filled with good things. You know, when you touch the mountains, they smoke. David is overcome with the order of God, how these things come to order. A doctor that has looked within the organs of the human body many times just says, "Wow, this isn't just some freak." And the same individuals, many times, who believe that with their whole heart, still say she's just a lucky lottery winner. That it could have been anything. It couldn't have been just anyone. Not from God's perspective. He picked her. And he chose her in such a way and told us straight from the beginning of her life that she would be holy. We heard it. The high priest does not go into the Holy of Holies. That's the order. The order is that he doesn't go in the Holy of Holies except for once a year. And he's the only one that can. Well, not exactly. Because that's what we celebrate today. We celebrate a young, barely a young girl, you know, just barely walking and beyond a certain age, Anna fulfilling her promise to bring the Virgin Mary into the temple. And when the high priest saw her, he brought her in to a place he's not even allowed to go at that time. It wasn't some sort of, he lost his brain. No, it was right. It was glorious. It was holy. It was just. It's the only time that the temple of God entered the temple of God. And may I remind us that not even Jesus, as a man, walked back there. We have no evidence that any time he entered the temple, he pushed the priest aside and said, "I'm going. He's my father. I'm going." Never. Not even the Son of God on this earth did that. Who did it? She did. By gender it was impossible, by age it was impossible, and by location it was impossible, and by timing. It was impossible for her to end. And yet she did. And it's how she entered that makes it so glorious. That was not what she was expecting. She was not expecting, when she walked in, to be taken into that way. All she was expecting was to what? Praise God. To worship him. To glorify him. To dedicate herself to him. Doesn't it make it seem that that's the way we need to enter the temple at all times in our lives? Isn't that how we should walk into church with the expectation? Not that we're going to be the have some right here. That we're going to just glorify God. We're going to march up and say, I belong here. But with a sense of awe. With a sense of humility. With a sense of obedience. And virtue before the Lord as we enter the church. Leaving our cares way back there. Picking them up only when we leave. And giving God everything we have as we enter this altar, as we enter this church, as we enter this sanctuary, as we become one with Him. That's really where, once we get past the theological understanding of how the temple entered the temple, which is pretty cool, once we get past that, what's left? It's our response. May we always have the same glory and love for the temple of God that the living temple of God had when she entered the Holy of Holies. And if we do not have that, may we enter then the trepidation for fear that we are judged and condemned simply by entering. That's the witness of what we have today in this feast. That's the glory by which God honored His mother when she was knee-high to the grasshopper. And that's the way we must allow ourselves to approach our Lord. With humility. With obedience. Such as and with such as what we heard in the gospel and in the epistle today. May the Lord, through the feast of the entrance of the veiled focus, continue to bless our lives and continue to help us to enter into the glory of the Lord as the beginning of the day. Please let us rise and continue our divine prayer. Catechumens depart, catechumens, all catechumens depart, let no catechumen remain, only the faithful again and again in peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom, we give thanks to you, Lord God of hosts, who have made us worthy to stand even now before your holy altar, and to fall down before your compassions for our sins and ignorance of the people. Receive our supplications, O God, make us worthy to offer to you, unto you, prayers and supplications, and both sacrifices for all your people. And enable us to be a place in this your ministry by the power of the Holy Spirit, blamelessly and without offense, and the pure witness of our conscience, to call upon you at all times and in every place, that hearing us, you may show mercy upon us according to the multitude of your goodness. For to you are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, unto the ages of ages. Again and again, peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom, again we bow before you and praise you, O good loving God, hear our supplications. Cleanse our souls and bodies, remember the Father, the flesh and spirit, and grant that we may stand before your Lord, all the without blame or condemnation. Grant also, O God, progress in life, faith and spiritual discernment, the faithful pray with us, so that they may always worship you with reverence and love, partake of your holy mysteries without blame or condemnation, and become worthy of your heavenly kingdom. And grant that always guarded by your power, we may give glory to you, the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, and to the ages of ages. sacraments may increase the communion, including may your good grace, spirit, may abide with us, and may be presented to the public. Deliver us to your own God, Son, and we are blessed. Together with your all holy and light, grace, spirit, with us forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be with you all.
See?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Μετά φόβου Θεού πίστεως και αγάπης προσεύχεται with the fear of God, with faith and with love draw near.
Thank you.
Thanksgiving prophecies in anticipation since it is a new day. So God bless you, King God. Please come forth to receive your blessing.